Today, we're going to be going through 5 different ways you can simplify your ClickUp strategy because ClickUp's not supposed to be something you spend months and months stressing about, even though many of us do. And these are 5 tips to make it a little bit less stressful. Ooh, and before we dive in, if you don't know me, hello, my name is Layla. I'm a ClickUp consultant, process geek. I've been doing a lot of videos all about how you can use ClickUp to build stronger processes in your business. I have a membership course consulting about it. So if you have any questions about how to use ClickUp in any way, really, be sure to subscribe to this channel. Check out the playlist, and of course, check out the description below for some great resources. But without further ado, let's dive into today's question about how to simplify your ClickUp experience. Rule number 1 is describe everything. This means views, lists, and automations. The fact of the matter is, ClickUp has already thought of clever ways that you can document your journey as you go through ClickUp. It is up to us to actually use them. So for example, it's pretty common for me to see structures like this inside ClickUp. And what I'm referring to with this is this kind of thing, where we're seeing views with no meaningful name, things like list and board and calendar, the default boring, thoughtless, and thankless views that you can use to organize your work in ClickUp. What is list telling me? Nothing. Nothing. It is telling me nothing helpful. So what I would suggest doing in here, if you haven't already, is go through every view and tell me what the heck it is showing me. So maybe this is all tasks. We know it's a list by the symbol. We don't need to write it twice. Maybe this board view, rather than also showing me all tasks, maybe we show it to be my tasks. And we set this view up to be a personal view. So people only see their own tasks assigned to themselves. If they have nothing, it shows up as nothing. But if something is assigned to them for some reason, when they're under my tasks, it'll show up right here. All of a sudden, we've gone from having generic, unhelpful views to having descriptive names that actually help people navigate the area. So whether it's for views or for things like automations where we can have descriptions, or even our list and folder names, try to make use of these spaces and make them actually descriptive. I want to see something that's actually going to help you or your team use these areas and know what they're for without you having to explain them. So that is rule of thumb number 1, describe everything, label everything. I know you can do it. Stick with it. Next up is limit permissions. Share only what is necessary. This is one that's sometimes hard for people to wrap their head around. The fact is, you might be someone who wants to know everything. In fact, if you're watching these videos, I have a hunch that you are someone who likes to have your nose in everything. You want to know how everything's doing. You are that kind of person. You care. But your team, even if they're the boss of the company, may not care. And in fact, it's actually not very helpful for you to share more information than most people need because it's distracting. So within ClickUp, we have all of these different layers of stuff by which we can organize information. You can see all this junk I have in here. And for me, and probably for you, I'd want to see all this. I want to know the big context. I want to see every task that someone's working on because it's interesting to me. It helps me figure out how the process can be better. But people who are trying to just get the work done, this is not a helpful view. We don't want to see every single possible thing we could possibly look at. This is not helpful. So whether it's for the space where you adjust permissions, or the folder where you adjust permissions, or the list where you adjust permissions, I want you to make sure that every single thing people are seeing is something that's actually helpful to them. It's actually going to help them do their job. And keep in mind, this is a spectrum. There are layers of permissions. So if someone needs to see something but not comment, well, that's great. Let's make sure they can see something but not comment, right? We can adjust this per layer. But if someone doesn't need to see something at all, just go ahead and remove them. It is better for someone to see less and ask you when they need it, for them to consistently see more, not know what it is, feel confused by it, and see these folders and sections that don't make sense to them. I mean, if we really want to have our team feel comfortable in ClickUp, it would be so much easier if we have to only teach them about half as much because they only see half of what is there. So that is on us to simplify things just by making sure our permissions are in check, which can be at the space, the folder, the list, or even the task level. That is rule of thumb number 2, which is adjusting those permissions. That brings us to number 3, which is simplify your statuses. Use statuses for essential information that you want to see at a glance and nothing else. Now, this is one I've already talked about so many times, so we're going to keep it brief in this brief video. But when you're modifying your statuses in ClickUp, it can be very tempting at first. I did it, you did it, we all probably have done it, to go in here and have some kind of crazy statuses. Most of ClickUp's templates do something similar, where there's a status for everything. Even like scratching your ear has its own status. You have a status for every possibility. And the problem with having this many statuses, besides the one that I've already talked about in this video, talking about the benefits of simple statuses, is when you have a lot of statuses and you have a task going through the flow, let's just view it in a board view so you can get the full picture here, is sometimes statuses then move forward and then backward and then forward, but then backward and then forward and then backward, and then no one really knows where it goes next. I'm here, I just finished LJK, LJK, and I'm not sure if it goes to scratch ears next or if it goes all the way back to in progress next. My statuses are all over the place and I'm not sure where I go next. So I'm just gonna go ahead and leave it here until my boss notices it. These kinds of problems come up when we have really complex statuses that don't follow a linear order. That's why a simpler status structure of something like to do complete, to do in progress complete, to do in progress review complete, where it's very clear what each step means, can be very helpful. And instead, pairing things with a custom field for the details. We just want to keep our statuses for the stuff that we want to see at a high level. So rather than all this stuff, let's just simplify these statuses for the list to be something simple, like to do and complete. Now, before I do that, I want to highlight one feature that's going to change here. And one helpful thing about this is that right now, because we have all these statuses, we have a status box. But if I go in here and I go to edit list statuses and I go back to my default space statuses, I'm going to have to resave these. Bam. You see that? You see the fact that it changed back to a check mark? Talk about simplicity. I may not know ClickUp, but I sure as hell know what a check mark is. And that is what we can do to simplify this experience. And once again, this is a little thing that's going to help someone who's not used to ClickUp feel comfortable that much sooner. It's just by the familiarity of a check mark versus having to go in and check this box and figure out what the heck the box is actually doing. So that is our tip here, which is just simplify your statuses. Use them for essential info only. Make it very clear what they mean. And if you can bear it, try to simplify it down to two. So that way you have that nice little check mark icon. Next up, reduce required views. If you're not using them, get rid of them. And honestly, this applies to pretty much everything in ClickUp. If you are not using the thing, get rid of it. Get it out of your ClickUp. Get it out of your life. Marie Kondo your ClickUp account, folks, because the more stuff you have there, the more stuff you have to teach and maintain, and it's just not worth the work. So for the specific one that I'm talking about here, I am talking about the required views. So odds are you guys are familiar with this menu. This is found by going under a space, clicking on space settings, and going under default settings for views. This is where you decide what views are on by default when you create something in this space. And for many of you, I've seen it time and time again, you treat ClickUp like other tools where I need to check these boxes if I ever want to use them, which I understand, that makes sense. But the fact is ClickUp is not like other tools in this regard. If you check these boxes, it's not that you're able to use them. These boxes require you to use them. So once I check these boxes and I click review changes, save changes, ba ba ba. Now I've got those views in every single folder, every single list, every single spot inside this entire space has all of those views. So overwhelmingly, that's not gonna be something that's gonna be helpful to most teams, because very rarely am I gonna need the same views on this list as I'm gonna need on this folder, as I'm gonna need on this space. Most often, these are each telling me something different, and so I'd wanna see different views. So to take action on this step, if there are required views that you don't actually want to require, get rid of them, okay? Just get rid of them, you don't need them. So we're gonna go back into this space, click on the three dots, click space settings, and go to default settings for views. And now we're just gonna toggle these off. Say I don't need these, maybe I do like board view always being there, but the rest of them I don't always need. So I'm gonna go ahead, review changes, and then save changes. Now we just see list and board view being required, which is much less clutter, much clearer, much less overwhelming. We probably do wanna name these still using some view templates, but this is still progress because it's just less noise that we have to worry about. And even once we're in here, just to clarify this, I can still choose to add a crazy, you know, whatever other random view I might wanna have. The difference is by adding them one at a time, I don't have to have them apply everywhere. So if I go maybe onto this list, that workload view is not there, but if I go to the folder, it is. And this versatility is one reason why having less required views is actually better and more flexible than having every single view be required. Last but not least, if you are naming something, use a convention. And this is really only relevant for the areas where we don't have good folder structure. So for example, the ClickUp hierarchy kind of already has a naming convention by having folders and lists inside them. But things like docs and templates and even certain tasks it can be kind of cluttered to just have them floating around on their own. So rather than having a docs area that looks like this, or a template center that looks like this, let's go ahead and add some naming conventions using prefixes to help us keep these things organized. And if you're not sure what a naming convention is, I actually talk about it in my simple reference docs video up here. Basically, it's a way for you to title things that is kind of like a shorthand for a broader meaning. So for example, every client we might have, we might call it client dash name of client. So we have that little word client in front of it. So we know that every single time we see that prefix, that word before the word, we know that we're talking about a client file. Prefix and suffixes are just a naming convention we can use to make text fields a little bit more descriptive than just having the name of the thing. And actually this wasn't planned, but you can see one of the prefixes that we use inside our template area to keep things organized. This prefix here of the yellow circle and then the dash, this is how we keep track of all templates that we use inside ClickUp. And we have different versions of it here, but this is a prefix. That way, every time when I'm scrolling through all of my templates, if I see that yellow dot, I know I'm looking at something that is made for ClickUp. And that's giving me a category where these categories just don't quite cut it. So for example, here we see we have four tasks around recurrence. To me, maybe that makes sense to have as a category. So we're actually going to go in here. Let's add an emoji of recur. And we'll start naming our things in a way that makes sense for the recurrence. So this is recurrence daily. This is recurrence after 14 days after completion. And we're just giving these kind of a visual guide so that when we're looking at them later, we know that we're talking about recurrence. We don't have to worry about one being spelled recur, one being recurring, one being recurrence. We just have one consistent symbol. So if I was looking for templates around recurrence, I could just search that icon, and look, all of my recurrence icons show up. And to be clear, yes, I could use tags as well. They're actually built into the template area, but they just don't quite work as well, and they're not quite as universal as a prefix and suffix system. So that's what I'm sticking with at this point. Eventually, I'm sure the tag system is going to become more powerful and it'll be worth it. At this point, not really. So this is a way to do it, but I'll say you can also do the same thing for documents. So for example, we have tons of documents here, and at this point in time, ClickUp does not have folders for their documents. So maybe we have tons of kind of scratch pad notes. Well, maybe every time we create a doc that's just a scratch pad, we start it off with a brain emoji. And then we do, you know, maybe the date. This is a system for us to know that all of the ones with brains are just brainstorming. We don't have to worry about what the heck are they or clicking them open or trying to search each one. We've got that naming convention down. Similarly, we have here team handbook, or maybe we want to do project plan. Maybe it's project plan John Doe. And on the next one, we have project plan Jane Doe. What matters is we're giving ourselves kind of a shorthand for organizing things, especially in places where folders don't quite exist yet. And they just help keep things a bit more organized. So if you are someone especially feeling frustrated around docs or template management, consider using this kind of suffix or prefix structure in order to give yourself a bit of a naming convention for your docs. And of course, if you're using naming conventions, write them down somewhere. Do not just try to remember that brain means brainstorm and this means that, because it's going to become too much. Make sure you have that written down somewhere, such as in your file naming conventions thing, which again, I've already talked about. It's still in the info card. Click on the little I up here. Watch that video and you can see kind of what our conventions break down for here. But to recap, those are the five tips I have for how you can simplify your ClickUp structure. Describe everything, limit permissions, simplify statuses, reduce required views. I already forgot the fourth one. I was really trying to remember all four of them. I can't remember. Okay, reduce required views. And fifth and finally, use naming conventions as prefixes or suffixes for the stuff that can't otherwise be organically organized in some way. I hope this was a helpful video for you. If you did enjoy it, please do give this video a thumbs up. And if you'd enjoy seeing five more tips just like this, because I did have to cut this down. I actually originally had 12 and then I was like, oh, this is gonna be a really long video. So we got five. If you'd like to see more tips like this, just leave a comment in the description. I'd be happy to do a part two for this video. I'll just wait to hear on your feedback on that one. But otherwise, thank you so much for watching. And until next time, enjoy the process.